Hey guys, sad news. This is gonna be my final video log. For those of you who have heard the rumor, I guess it's true. I am coming home. Not really thrilled about it, but I guess you can say I'm at peace with it. I've ran out of money, and the ticket that we were issued at the beginning of this trip is really restrictive, so you can't really change our date of like departure back until like April 7th, and that's just not gonna work for me because I'm running out of cash pretty fast. I did find my way home, well, not yet, but I bought tickets home, and it's gonna be about 2 days of travel, and I will be home at 11:45 in Winnipeg on Tuesday night. That's almost midnight. I don't expect anyone at the airport really, besides like maybe my family and my girlfriend, but for those of you who want to know, that's the time. I had a good idea that I could do a little question and answer thing for the last video log, so you guys can get into my head about what I'm thinking and what I thought about the trip. So here you go. If I could do it all over again, I know we're promoting Swap on our website, but sorry guys, I'm gonna have to not go with Swap if I did it again. I quickly realized when I got here, after a week or two time, I didn't want to work over here. I'd rather spend my time enjoying it and soaking it all up, going to places and being a tourist. Before I came here, I really wanted to be a local and fit in, and then I learned that that's just not what I want to do. So if I did it all over again, I wouldn't go through Swap. I'd come here on my own terms, buy my own ticket, and I'd go wherever I wanted, whenever I wanted. That could be more expensive because, I mean, we're not working, but I think I'd have a lot better time. I think the best decision I made while over here, well, it was actually a team decision by me and Kevin, is that just stop living like hermits. We went job hunting, we countless resumes, and no luck, and it was so depressing. We'd come back to our hostel, we'd sleep, and then we'd go out the next morning and do the same thing. While that, we're eating apples and water, and we didn't go out at all. We weren't enjoying ourselves. So we got together and we talked about it and we said, we're not having fun, so let's have fun. And then after that decision was made, I can honestly say like that was like the best month of my life, because I've never had that much fun in that amount of time. So that decision really changed the trip for me. The highlight for the trip for me was definitely the week of the Shamrock Tour. I've never met so many cool people in a week, and it was awesome to have Kelsey with us. I've also never drank so much alcohol in a week, which made for great times. I got to see a lot of Ireland in 5 days. I got to do a lot of the stuff that you're supposed to do while you're here, kiss the Blarney Stone, see the cliffs. And we had an awesome tour guide that just was full of life and loves Ireland. I learned a lot about the history, which was actually not as boring as I thought. I learned a lot of words. And I'm more than happy to pay what we did to take that tour. What did I miss about home? Well, it's easy to say everything. It's also easy to say my bed, my room, my shower. But I don't mean this to sound cliche at all, but I definitely just miss my family and friends. Because it's pretty safe to say I would live in Ireland in a heartbeat. I've loved it over here. But over Winnipeg being my home, I would never live anywhere else. Home is definitely where your friends are and family are, and I've come to learn that. So I definitely miss my family. I missed all my good friends. I miss just like the simple things, waking up, going to work, and then coming back and just playing video games with Brett. Just like a day like that. I missed. And I guess that's you guys on the other side are just like, what? You guys are in Ireland. How can you miss that? But it's definitely just the little things that you miss and you don't realize until you're gone. So yeah, definitely miss my family and friends. Well, I've definitely learned a lot by being over here. There's really a lot I could say to answer that question, but the most important thing is that I think I take my family for granted. Being on my own for the last 6 weeks or so, I've definitely realized that I don't thank them enough and how supportive they are of me. That goes along with my, I guess, extended family, like my girlfriend, my best friends, and I take the people that are close to me for granted. And when I get back, I'd like to change that because it's not fair for them to not realize what they're doing for me and how easy they make my life. Because once being over here and being on my own, well, I'm with Kevin, which is awesome and it's a great help, but it's definitely an eye-opener, and I hope to change things once I get home. Was this trip a success? It's pretty hard not to say it wasn't. Even though I'm coming home a lot earlier than I expected to, and we didn't find work, and it was pretty much a letdown when it came to finding a job here, but if you ask me if this trip was a success, I'd say yes, a huge success, because I've learned so much about myself in the time I've been here, and which is a small time. It's only been about 5, 6 weeks, and I've learned so much, and I'm confident in saying I'm a lot better person coming back now. And I think that's good for me. This was a good experience, even though I am coming home early, but it was a fantastic experience, and I will never forget it, and I can't wait to have more. One word, probably fan-feckin-tastic. This trip was fan-feckin-tastic. So I hope you guys enjoyed that little Q&A there. I guess it gives me a chance to kind of reflect, not to sound all cheesy and all, but then it gets you guys just to know how I'm feeling. And for those of you that are planning on coming on a swap adventure, I guess this gives you a good idea of how you're gonna feel when you leave. So again, I'm gonna be back in Winnipeg on Tuesday around midnight. I'm not the guy that expects a big parade at the airport. I don't even want that. But I will be back on Tuesday. Kevin is staying here, if you guys haven't realized that. He's staying here. He's gonna do his own thing, and I'm super proud of him because I would definitely be in the same boat. I'd do the same thing if I had his funds. And yeah, keep following him, and hopefully his vlogs are just as good while I'm gone. Take care, guys. It's been a blast.
Won't you have to sing another song of freedom? 'Cause all I